Now, when we run our program, you can see that there's a message with instructions and another one saying that we exited with the code 0. Basically, it means that the program terminated itself. That's because there's just one instruction in this program, which is print hello world. But now, let's learn a little bit of C# syntax for the first time. By syntax, what I mean is all the keywords, the operators, anything that the compiler recognizes as C# and that it will translate to the computer. After all, C# is a programming language, and like any other language, it has a syntax. And the first element of the syntax that we're going to learn is the comment. In our first line of code, we have this green text preceded by two forward slashes. And that is code that the compiler will ignore. So this code won't do anything because of the two forward slashes. And comments are useful for many reasons. You can display some extra information. You can explain your thought process. We can communicate with other developers that are working on the same code or anyone that's just analyzing it. Or it can even be a command that you're not using right now and you don't want to delete just yet. So it's a very useful tool. Then we have this console written in green, and that's a class, one of the most important concepts in object-oriented programming. We're going to explain classes in detail later, but for now, just think of classes as a way to store and organize all the methods that do similar things. So as the name says, this is a class that's responsible for operations in the console. And we're going to write our own classes later. The console class is being provided by .NET class library. .NET has thousands of classes that help us solve common problems, such as talking to databases, creating HTTP requests, creating user interfaces, and of course, dealing with the console. And each class has several methods. Each method is responsible for doing one specific thing. In this situation here, we have the write line, which does exactly what it says. It writes a line in the console, and you can tell that this is a method because it has this parenthesis after it, and not all methods have parentheses, but a word followed by parenthesis usually is a method. And if you want to invoke a method, then you need the parenthesis. And lots of methods require arguments. So these are pieces of data that you can pass to the method so they can perform whatever function they need to perform. And we're going to see more about that later when we create our own methods. And here we are passing what we want to print. Technically, we call this a string literal. And basically, this means that we literally want each of these characters to be printed as an output. Then we have the semicolon, which is the end of statement operator, and it tells the compiler that we finished the command. And that's a statement. This line of code is a statement, which is a complete instruction in C#. And believe it or not, you just learned the most important thing in C#. Most of the times, from now on, when you sit down to code, you're going to be writing statements just like this one, with the same structure. You have a class, you have a method in a class separated by a period, which we call a member access operator, and we have the parentheses with or without arguments. So now that we know what a statement is, let's write a statement. I want to modify this program so that it doesn't close itself. I'm going to use the console class again, but this time we will call a different method. We will call readline. And that means that it's waiting for the user's input. So nothing will happen from here unless there's an user's input. In this case, the user's input will be the keyboard. So it's waiting for us to press any key in the keyboard. So if we run the program again, we can see that the execution is paused. It's waiting for me. And once I press a key, the program terminates itself. So that's it. We learned what a statement is. We created our own statement. But before we continue learning the syntax, I want to talk a little bit about something that I was very curious about when I first started programming. I remember that when I started, it instantly clicked for me. I was just in love with coding from the beginning, and I was learning every day. I was absolutely obsessed. And every day I tried to create something a little bit more interesting, a little bit more complicated. But then all of a sudden I asked myself, okay, I'm writing these interesting programs. What if I want someone to actually use it? So let's say I create some fancy calculator for my mom. Or if you create a little quiz game application for your brother or your sister to study. How are they going to use it? Because right now they would have to open Visual Studio, run the application, and only then they would see the command line. So I'm going to show you a very simple way to publish your application. And by publishing, I mean it will be accessible to anyone that uses your computer or anyone that gets these files into their computer. So we're going to click on the Build tab and select Publish Selection. Here, you're going to target a folder, click on Next, and choose the folder that you want to use. So here, I'm going to create a couple of folders, and of course, you can publish it wherever you want, in a folder of any name that you choose. So here, I have a folder next to my study folders, and I'm creating a subfolder for this specific project. Then I'm clicking on OK and Finish. And finally, in this window, I can click on Publish. So here we have debug and release options in terms of configuration, but we're going to keep everything as is. And if we hit Publish, it says it's publishing to a folder. You can see the output down here. Then Publish succeeded. So let's go to the folder that we created. Let's try to find the project. So here we can go to the executable file and let's see what happens when we click on it. The program is there exactly how we wrote it. So not only we wrote our first program, we modified it, and we published for other people to use it. Just bear in mind that you need all of these files if you want the program to run. So if you just take the executable file, it's not going to work on its own.